we're good to go. Okay, how much math is really needed to become a software engineer? Do you really need to be a math whiz in order to become one? This is a question that has been asked over and over again, and I really want to share with you my perspective as someone who is a software engineer but took a different path. And I'll be very honest, during school, especially in high school, math was not my strongest subject. Okay, let's just dive right into it. I'm gonna save you the trouble of even having to watch this entire video, although wait, I really hope you do, because there's a lot of valuable information that I have in it, but I wanna give it right off the top of the video, the answer is, do you have to be a math whiz, a math pro, in order to become a software engineer? The answer is no, you don't. Is math important in software engineering? The answer is yes and no, kind of. I'm gonna stay neutral on that one, and I'll explain to you why later on in this video. Now, I always have to add a disclaimer for these kind of videos because there's always people who have very strong opinions, which is great. I like to remain in the middle and neutral to just provide you the facts and proper information. But my disclaimer is that yes, there are always exceptions to the rule. So this is based off of my experience talking to colleagues in the industry, friends in the industry, and of course there are some software engineers that use math on a day-to-day basis, which we will get into, but for the most part, you don't need to be a math bro. Let's start off by talking about what software engineering really is. Software engineering is kind of a broad term when you think about it. There is a lot of roles that can be housed under software engineering, a lot of specialty positions that you can get into with software engineering skills. I really want to first talk about what exactly software engineering is, because without having an understanding of what software engineering is, we can't really get into the math question. Okay, let's go to our favorite tool we always use, which is Google. And search simply is, what is software engineering? Well, one of the answers that comes up right away is, software engineering is defined as a process of analyzing user requirements and then designing, building, and testing software application which will satisfy those requirements. Okay, within this definition, I feel like there are quite a few roles already that were listed, from testing software, okay, that would be QA, to analyzing user requirements, maybe that would be UI UX, maybe that would be business analyst, and designing, that would be designer. So as you can see already, it's quite a broad term with many different roles that can be housed under it. So now that we have a sense of what exactly software engineering is, it's essentially building, let's put it in one sentence, software engineers build stuff. Okay, that might be too simple, but getting to the point of software engineering is a broad term and there are lots of roles under it. Lots of different specialties, from game development to mobile development, web, maybe you want to be more on the security team, different things like that. Of course, these roles have their unique and specific names as well, but oftentimes you go to school for software engineering, you self-teach software engineering, whatever your path is, and then you kind of narrow down into different roles. Before we get into it though, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related videos. Shout out to some of these subscribers here. Thank you for your questions, comments, feedback, and most importantly, your support and love. Okay, now that we have that covered, where did this question even come from? If math isn't really required as a software engineer on average, why is this question so popular? This is something that I was thinking the other day, is why do people always ask this question if it's not a huge factor in becoming a software engineer to be a pro at math? And I think it really comes from the fact of not math as a skill itself, but what skills math gives you. Let me explain. Typically, not always, but typically, people who are good at math are very logical thinkers, good at problem solving, good at breaking down problems. Those are the skills that are used in software engineering. You need in software engineering to have logic. You need to be able to break down problems. You need to be able to see something as a whole and then break it down into pieces, but also see the big picture. A lot of these skills are taught with and you gain if you are good at math or someone who enjoys to do math. Now, that doesn't mean if you aren't good at math, you can't pick up these skills. Someone once phrased it to me really, really well, I thought, that learning how to code and getting into software engineering, you are training your brain to think in an entirely new way. And if you haven't really used your muscles for that way of thinking, for the math and the science and different things like that before, it's going to take you a bit of extra time to train your brain to think in these ways. It doesn't mean that if you are bad at math, you can't become a great software engineer. It just may take you a bit longer to kind of get those muscles to the point that they are ready, just keep on working them and they will get strong as well. Whereas someone who maybe is already amazing at math, that learns coding and becomes a software engineer, maybe it'll be much easier for them because they already have those problem-solving skills, just applying it to a different format. Okay, and that brings me to my next question is, why is logic important? Why is being a logical thinker or having these skill sets important in software engineering? How is it really used? And my answer to that is being a logical thinker and being able to really utilize strong problem-solving skills will help you because essentially when you're coding, you're talking to a computer. That's all you're doing. This computer does not have emotions, well, yet anyways. Probably in the future they will. But this computer doesn't have emotions. It cannot think for itself, once again, yet anyways. And it needs you to tell it what to do, what program to build. And this isn't done with a wishy-washy, oh, I would like to have this, but maybe this. It's done with a matter-of-fact way, whereas this, if I type this, it will produce this. If I put in this, it will output this. And it's simple, it's black and white. There's obviously a lot of gray areas in software engineering, but at the end of the day, if you build something with a certain specific code, you know what output you will get. And with that comes logic. It comes thinking of, okay, more in a clarity sense and thinking in a problem-solving sense that you know what you input, you will get outputted. And sometimes if you don't have that logical side to you and you try and do it, you can get maybe too emotional or too thinking, why isn't this working? I don't see the results happening. And at the end of the day, it's as simple as you put something in, you receive something out. I don't know if that makes sense to you. I hope it does. That was how I really thought of it. And with problem solving, it's so important because when you are working on a defect, when you are working on a bug, sometimes when you look at the big picture, it is so intimidating and you don't know how you will ever start breaking it down. You need to be a good problem solver that you can see, really explain what the problem is and break it down. Once again, all these skills can be learned even if you are not a strong person in math. It just might take you a bit longer. Okay, I hope you found this video very valuable and helpful as to do you need to be a math pro or have strong math skills to become a software engineer. At the end of the day, not a lot of math is required in software engineering. On my day-to-day basis, I do both front-end and back-end. Right now, I'm doing more front-end work, but I don't use math on a day-to-day, but I do use logic and problem-solving every single day. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and also leave in the comments other videos you want to see. Thanks, everyone.